In this video, we'll check this Gensler amplification stack. We have the Magellan 800 head and the base array 12-3 cabinets. We have the straight one and the slanted one. Let's get started. This is Gregor from BassDevil.com, and in this video I will review this beautiful Gensler amplification stack here. Jeff Gensler, the founder of the company, is not exactly new to the business. Some of you might know that he was also the founder of Gens Benz, I don't know how it's pronounced correctly, it doesn't matter. He had another bass amp company before, and those amps were brilliant, especially at the time when he started doing Class D stuff. I think they were really groundbreaking good amps at the time, and this company was eventually bought by Fender and also retired by them, because that's what they do. However, those amps were brilliant, but compared to what he's doing now, well, let's find out. So let's start with the Magellan head. This is an 800 watt Class D amp that should be loud enough for any application, for any gig that might come across your way. The minimum load is 2 point something ohms, which is really cool, so you can combine up to 3 different 8 ohm cabinets, which in the Gensler world looks like this. Really cool. The Magellan head is one of the most versatile amps out there. It's like a Swiss Army knife for bass players. On the front we have the regular controls for gain, a 3-band EQ with a sweepable mid-range and a master volume, but also a drive and a contour section. Let's check the drive out. As you've heard, the drive is not really a high gain distortion, it's rather a tool to dirty up your bass tones a little bit. Of course, not everyone will need this, but I think it's still very useful and it's cool that it's there. I personally would use it, for example, in lower settings to create really nice warm P bass tones and these kind of things. Next section we're looking into is the contour. On many amps that have contour controls or dials or whatever, I honestly don't really like them because they often alienate the amp, and I think they often are just not very useful. Here, however, I think they made a great job. We have two different settings. The first one is when the blue light is on, and in this case you get a mid-scoop sound. So the more you dial it in, the more mids get lost, and you can create modern slap sounds, metal sounds, these kind of things. The other one is more on the vintage side of things. So when you dial it in, you get rid of highs, the mids come a little bit more out, and I think this is actually a very nice sound, and it's very, very useful. And I think especially great for those who like this amp but don't want to go with this super wide range and kind of hi-fi sound. It's not really a hi-fi sound, it's a natural sounding amp, but yeah, it's still very open and there's everything. And for those who like their bass tones a little bit more vintagey, a little bit more limited, they will have a lot of fun with this. The amp on its own without the drive and the contour sounds very clean and neutral and almost linear, and I think this acts like a blank canvas that can just become anything you want it to be. So you can work with different basses or different pedals, and this amp will always give you all the details and all the little sound bits that you want to hear, and I think this is very nice. I personally think it's one of the best sounding Class E amps out there, definitely in the moment, and with those 800 watts you definitely don't have to worry, there's always enough headroom, so you will never run out of power. On the back we have a lot of stuff. We have two speaker outs, an impedancy switch, a headphone out, an FX loop, an aux in, a tuner out, a power amp in, a foot switch connector, and one of the best sounding D-outs I've ever heard from any bass amp. It even allows you to switch between line and mic level. It is just brilliant, and I think it doesn't get much more professional in a bass amp. Another cool feature is the built-in universal power supply that allows you to use the amp with any voltage. No matter where you are in the world, this amp will work. I'm sure the look of those bass array cabinets might confuse some viewers, because speakers in front of other speakers is something that we don't get to see very often in the bass world. But don't worry, this is not a gimmick or a compromise, it's just a very smart solution. Each cabinet comes with a 12-inch speaker for all the lows and the mids, and 4 3-inch neodymium drivers for all the top end. I don't think there's a need to go too much into details what's going on here, just the sound is very natural and very detailed, and I think it's a perfect combination of giving you the full range of your bass sound by still maintaining a very natural feeling, and I think the combination is just brilliant. Gensler offers different versions of this cabinet that you can combine as you like. In this case, I have the slanted one at the bottom and a straight one on top, but you can also reverse them or just use only slanted, only straight, whatever you like. If I would buy such a stack, I would definitely go with 2 or 3 of the slanted ones, because they will give you the same advantage that monitor wedges give you on stage. They will aim the sound directly at you and not at your feet as all the other bass cabinets out there do. And what's really cool about this is you can actually keep your stage volume a little bit lower and still hear yourself properly. And let's be honest, it also looks freaking cool. And these cabinets are very lightweight, they weigh only 15 kilos each, so you can basically put the amp in your bass bag, grab one of these cabinets in each hand, and there you go with your entire bass rig. Cool. So if you're on the market for a super versatile and lightweight bass amp, or for super lightweight cabinets, I definitely recommend to check this one out. I rarely get excited by Class D amps, because I'm an old school studio guy, I like my amps heavy, but if I was a live musician and I would need to carry my stuff around all the time, I think this would be my top choice right now. Of course, there are a lot of good sounding Class D amps out there, but this one is so versatile and it would definitely give me the confidence to be prepared for anything that will come my way as a live musician with different bands or whatever. So really cool, great job, Mr. Gensler, and yeah, that's it for today. If you have any questions regarding this empty cabinets, whatever, just leave them in the comment section below. I will gladly get back to you. And if you like this video, hit the like button below and subscribe to this channel if you want to see more of those. That's it for today. See you next time, and yeah, bye bye.